Winston Peters has likened co-governance to Nazi Germany in a fiery State of the Nation speech in Palmerston North. In front of a packed crowd, the Deputy Prime Minister slammed the state of the country and his political opponents. Senior political reporter Benedict Collins was there.
It was a rowdy reception for Winston Peters. Inside, the New Zealand First leader using a State of the Nation address to celebrate his own political resuscitation.
We got knocked down, but we got back up again.
And our Deputy Prime Minister spent most of his speech bemoaning the state of New Zealand.
We can't fix this country until we acknowledge what is wrong with it.
His supporters were clear why they'd turned up.
Everything he said about mostly the vaccine and the fact that he came to speak to the Parliament protesters, that was something that I was really passionate about.
Wouldn't miss it for the world. I've got to find out what's happening in New Zealand. We don't get it from the mainstream media.
And Mr. Peters stuck to his playbook, delivering his greatest hits, ripping on migration numbers.
We're not xenophobic, we're just not zombies.
And the media.
And by the way, can I say to you all in the media, welcome back.
He even invoked Nazis while discussing co-governance.
Their DNA made them somehow better than others. I've seen that sort of philosophy before. I saw it in Nazi Germany. We all did.
How do you think that would make our Jewish community feel?
Well, you're clairvoyant, are you? Well, I think that they would understand entirely what I'm saying.
He saved some venom for the Greens.
They couldn't run the school tuck shop.
And Labour.
And just recently, in a thing which was very apposite as to its title, the Labour Party went and had a retreat.
And the Foreign Minister's not laughing about his diplomatic boo-boo in India last week, where he caused a foreign policy storm by weighing in on the assassination of a Sikh in Canada.
It wasn't a controversy. I didn't say anything out of the water. I said what any darn trained lawyer would say. When the inquiry's over, we'll hear the evidence and we'll know exactly what they were saying.
Outside, these critics unimpressed with the power Mr. Peters is wielding.
So 6% or 8% gives you a mandate? I don't think so.
But that 6% has got New Zealand First back in the game. Benedict Collins, One News.